So I'm Dr. Lucy Jones. I'm a seismologist with the U.S. Geological Survey in Pasadena, and I am the science advisor for risk reduction. I began my work really in statistical seismology. When I went to graduate school, they were like, there was just an earthquake in China with over 500 foreshocks. Why don't we get you studying foreshocks? And it actually worked. I worked there. But then realized that for the same risk of an earthquake, we're going to have very different actions. And understanding that and recognizing that that decision really isn't a seismology decision, it really is a policymaker's decision, I decided to work on trying to develop statistics so we could transfer the seismological information to the policymaker who could use it. The process, of course, got me in front of the public because that was the whole point. We were trying to create information people could use. And that led to me being appointed to the California Seismic Safety Commission. And I saw how all of these people need our information and don't understand it. We actually held workshops with emergency managers, land use planners, and said, what do you need from science that you're not getting? And they gave us a very clear message that they wanted scenarios of the disasters because they knew they were preparing for a big earthquake and they didn't know what they were preparing for. It would have been impossible without SCEC because we were able to turn to SCEC, who was just developing the CyberShake program, and we got them to agree to use our model of a Southern San Andreas earthquake. And so we had different SCEC groups doing models, which allowed us to show, okay, yeah, there's a lot of hypothesizing, but look at these features are always the same. The LA Basin is getting hammered no matter who put the model together. And then we took all of that and we went to really, you know, researchers in social sciences, we had public health, economics, disaster, emergency management, really looking at the social implications, and that is what people needed to be able to act on it. So we created the shakeout drill as an event to raise awareness of the scenario. It actually was secondary to the scenario when it began, and of course it more than fulfilled its expectations, and we got a quarter of the population of Southern California to participate in that first one. And I think it's, you know, it sort of changed the way we saw these things of what was possible. What's your image of what happens in an earthquake? The building falls down and collapses on you. It really seems like being outside is safer. The reality that very few of our buildings fall down, that the outsides are much more likely to fall on you than being inside, that put that up against the visceral fear that the building is going to trap you and people run. So you really have to be very explicit about the education and about the training, about why this is a safer thing to do. You know, in 2014, I entered a very unusual agreement between the U.S. Geological Survey and the City of Los Angeles, essentially to implement the lessons of shakeout into the city plan. And the mayor was fantastic. He wants this. His senior staff worked with me throughout the year. We developed this plan, released it just as at the end of the year, and since then they've been continuing to implement it. And you know, if half of it goes through, it'll be the biggest change for seismic safety the city's ever seen. And it looks like it's all going through. You know, when I went to City Hall, I felt like I was so far away from what SCEC does normally that I was clear I was beyond the pale, as they say, and It was just, all right, I've chosen a different path. To then come to SCEC and find it being honored and recognized helped me see that it's, we all want to be part of this. We all want our science used. We have different skills in that process. But I could never have done what I've done without SCEC having been here to create the information that we then implemented in the city.